Hey guys, I want to do a quick video about something that recently happened to me and how I sorted through it and not got and I didn't get scammed. I have an acquaintance, a recent acquaintance in a Facebook group that I'm following, who made another acquaintance of somebody who does real estate financing, or at least claimed to. And anyways, we recently had a introduction over Facebook Messenger, and we made this introduction, and anyways, I'm having this conversation with him. I asked him for his email address, and first thing that kind of tipped me off about him was his email address. Not that email addresses are a telltale sign of a scammer, but it still kind of made me pause for a moment and question. This guy's name is Brent Murphy, at least he goes by that, and his email address is brentmurphyfinanceservice@gmail.com. Now, I would think a real professional here would probably have their own website, and their email address would be brent@murphyfinanceservice.com. But that's not always the case. There's quite a few private lenders out there that loan on real estate deals that are just people, and not a company. So that kind of made me take pause and question it a little bit more than I was already skeptical. I then went to his profile and anyways, took a look at his profile. It doesn't have a whole ton of pictures out there. I looked at where he's from, so he's out of country, and so not a whole lot here to kind of go off of. But I mean, everything looks pretty perfect. I mean, I don't know how many friends he's got, but I didn't even need to look at that so much as I follow this one trick. So what I do is to find out if this person is using somebody else's pictures or maybe going by a different name in order to scam, is if you click on the picture. Now, I can't do it right here. If I were to right click, it won't have it. But if I just click on the picture, it makes it full screen. And this is in Facebook. If I right click, I can hit Save Image As, and then I can save it to my desktop. So I have it on this PC Pictures, and I just created this folder called Scammers just for this. And I downloaded three of his pictures. Okay, just him, his profile picture, him on an airplane, and him in a hotel room taking a selfie in front of a mirror. So anyways, hit save. Then what I do is I go to Google. Oh, let's get rid of this. Well, let's just click here. Okay, so I'm in Google, and this is the Google intro page. Up in the right, you can go to Gmail, and you also go to Images. So I click on Images, and then it changes the screen. Now, what we normally know of Google Images is to just search an image with a keyword. So if you wanted to search waves, you could hit this and you get pictures of waves. Okay. Well, the other cool thing about Google Images is that you can actually upload a picture file. Google will scan it and then scan the internet to see if that picture is anywhere else on the internet. So what you can do is click on this picture, the camera icon, hit upload an image, or if you have it from a website, you can paste the website, but I get a little bit more specific. Hit upload an image, choose a file, and then go and find the that file folder that you saved his picture in, his or her picture in. Hit upload the file. And Google goes out and found his picture out on Instagram. So if you read through it, you know, Brandy Burridge has a follower on Instagram, so it looks like he's a follower. I think if we go to Justine here, you know, there's his picture right there, Pat. But what's this? Patrick Anthony. Okay, so he's got a different name, Patrick Anthony versus Brent Murphy. Okay, right there, immediately I know this guy is not, there's something questionable. Now, maybe this guy really is Brent Murphy and Patrick Anthony's the fake one, but nonetheless, something's not adding up. Okay, so you can kind of go through a little bit more. Anyways, you come down and I just clicked on the next page. The most common use of this picture is with a guy named Dr. Fernando Gomes Pinto. Okay, so if I click on this, it's on this website. And anyways, here he is. Okay, so right there we've got three people or three names to this face. So that right there just tells me something's not right. It looks like some scammer has done the same thing I did with right click, save picture as, and they created a profile under a different name but using this guy's picture. So really quick, just to go back through how to do that, do what I did is you just pull up the picture, you right click, save image as, you go to your desktop or some folder and create a folder if you want. That's what I did, just called it Scammers. And downloaded a couple pictures. Then you go back to Google. You go to Google Images. Go to Images. And then you can search by image by clicking this camera, uploading an image, choosing the file. Let's find this picture somewhere. And here we go, Dr. Fernando Gomes Pinto on Instagram. So Dr. Fernando had his identity stolen, and we didn't get scammed by Mr. Brent Murphy. So, anyways, hopefully that was helpful. Hopefully you guys avoid getting scammed by anybody by using this method to vet people out.